Welcome back, generals. We're playing Second Bull Run as the Union, a major general difficulty, in version 1.28.4 of the J&P mod. I fought the battle twice, and wouldn't you know it, the disorganized backyard brawl version resulted in more damage to the enemy and fewer casualties to my forces, so that's the one I'm moving forward with. Before we get started, I want to say thank you for taking the time to check out any of my materials related to the game. I hope that you find something to help you achieve success in your own campaigns. Do not hesitate to ask questions in the comments. Be aware that Colonel, Brigadier General, and Major General difficulties all share an AI profile. Legendary has its own profile. Therefore, things that you see me do should easily translate to lower difficulties but may not work in Legendary or be suboptimal. My career point from Thoroughfare Gap went into medicine. I didn't take anything further with reputation points. I have enough infantry weapons for now, so taking either of these weapons caches wasn't a priority. As usual, before a grand battle, I bought up all the heavy guns and the James rifles. I also bought up many cav and skirmisher weapons to use later in the campaign. The 4th Division of 1st Corps will not deploy to this battle because I expect to get a Day 2 victory and not go to Day 3, so that division is just getting training increases. All my rifled guns are here to start shelling the CSA fortifications. The smoothbores and infantry are there to fend off any AI attacks while my rifles do their work. My avatar commands the Corps. Brown has 1st Division with Franklin, Buckley, Porter, Henselman, and McDowell. Harlan has 2nd Division with Shermer, Peabody, Loomis, Root, and McCord. Grant has the 3rd Division with Raines, Keith, Hunton, Scales, and McKean. Gibbon has the 2nd Corps. The infantry in this corps will be my primary assault force once I start to move on Stony Ridge. The skirmishers and cav will travel together to flank to the far left. Bliss has 1st Division, which includes Brewster, Krasnowski, Hancock, Brooks, and Hunt. Stewart has 2nd Division with McClellan, Wagner, Maxwell, Woods, and Walton. Martin has 3rd Division with Froebel, Braxton, Christ, Reed, and Grimes. Merritt has 4th Division with Smith, Frank, Bernie, Martin, and Sullivan. Lomax has my 3rd Corps, which is nearly all reserve troops. 2 divisions will be holding my far right flank when the assault begins, and 2 will be coming up late to help support and clean up. Alabac has 1st Division, which consists of Lindsay, Gruce, McHenry, Hobson, and Toon. Reynolds has 2nd Division with Walton, Ames, Stewart, Nagel, and Veach. Keyes has 3rd Division with Lepian, Hall, Loomis, Minty, and Latimer. Hicks has 4th Division with Brayton, Farrell, Harlan, Bruce, and Weisinger. All 3 corps have 35,000 in supply. The AI received about 16,000 recruits after Thoroughfare Gap. The AI army is 56,000 above its default, and training is 45%, and armory is 44% above the default size. This mod version skips day 1 of Second Bull Run in the Union campaign, so I'll just move forward to the day 2 screens. The AI has 54,071 troops and 157 guns before unit splits are applied. I see 2-star skirmishers with Burnsides and DNNCs, maxed cav size, Napoleon's 12-pound howitzers, 2 and 3-star infantry, lots of Lorenz rifles in Tyler, Texas, some ordnance rifles. I'll be taking 53,627 troops and 176 guns. In the second Bull Run battle that I posted last year, I bulldozed my way through the far right flank and then swept from right to left to the VP. However, I had a bunch of Tier 1 melee perks for my infantry in that army. The shortest distance up to the VP is right through the gap in the fortifications where the corn and wheat fields are located. My main body is going to shell the fortifications on each side of the gap to soften them up. Part of my reinforcements are fast-moving cav and skirmishers, and when they arrive, they'll sweep around the left flank and come in from behind. Once I'm ready, my infantry will penetrate the line near the gap and cut off the AI forces that are on the far left from the rest of the army. I'll eliminate them and then head for the VP. Keep in mind that you must hold the VP through the contested timer to achieve victory without going to day 3. If the contested timer is still running when the mission timer expires, you will go to day 3 and AI will get significant reinforcements. The day 3 battle also requires that you capture other VPs, plus your army does not reset, so you'll have to start however you ended day 2. So if your units are low on ammo and in poor condition, you might face some serious trouble. I recommend only going to day 3 if you want to get the extra kills for the experience and the weapons recovery. If you do plan to go to day 3, then there's no need to be in a big rush to take the VP, and you can conserve some unit condition for fighting on the last day. We have 2 hours and 45 minutes to open the battle. I want to rush my detached skirmishers forward to get into the wood line before a bunch of AI skirmishers intercept my artillery. My infantry can then come in and set up a defensive line. My rifled guns will work on the fortification while my smoothbores help to repel any AI units that come down to attack. The AI profiles were not directly changed in 1.28, but all the other changes have caused the AI to be more aggressive than in the past. So don't be surprised if it comes out to engage in force rather than just sitting back and being passive. We can see the AI forces moving into the forward fortifications. I want to try to stay out of range of them while getting my artillery as close as possible to damage them. The AI's detached skirmishers are easy to detect and repel. However, if its dedicated skirmishers get a stealth perk, they can easily stay hidden while firing. So if you notice your troops are starting to take some damage, you'll need to push forward a skirmisher to scout it out, but that will put them in range of the infantry in the fortification.
Yeah.
scales his Napoleon battery is oversized, so I'm not worried if he takes a little bit of damage while everyone's getting into place. The first reinforcements arrive at the 2-hour mark. Second Corps, 1st and 2nd Divisions will be my primary assault force. Right now, they just need to move up and get into position and recover their condition so they're ready to move. I've played around with setting up some artillery in the far right flank a few times, but the AI sent out a full division to attack each time. I didn't want to devote that many men to protect them, so I just placed some detached skirmishers here and moved everyone else up to link up with the 1st Corps. Like many of my grand battles, the opening phase is mainly just getting units into place. Prioritizing getting my artillery onto the field early allows me to shell the enemy while everyone else is moving around. Thank you. You can see Early and Jenkins moving across here. From what I can tell, the AI normally moves about a division over to Bronner's farm, probably to thwart any flanking attacks. Some of them are further back and can't be seen from my position. Early and Jenkins will either be eliminated or adjust their route to get out of my range. For now, Jenkins is having a bad day. Early's been routed too. Looks like Jenkins will try again. I will adjust my fire with the CSA pulling back from the forward fortification. I want to push the unit out of the other fortification so I can move into the cover of the trees in front of it. You can see one of the artillery batteries moving to Bronner's farm there. I'll deal with them in just a bit. And new units moving into the fortification, so I'll work on that one for a bit. With 1 hour left, we get the rest of 2nd Corps. These are all cav and skirmishers. They will go take out whatever units went to Bronner's farm, and then they're going to move around behind the AI forces. Now I get part of 3rd Corps. These are smaller reserve troops. I mainly want them to seal the edge from the AI trying to flank me on the right after my assault begins. There are more units headed to Bronner's farm, so it's going to be a fun fight. Fire. I want my dedicated skirmishers to get close to attacking before I move my cav up. I'll get my other guns into place before I send infantry in to fire on the fortification. Time to start my attack. I'll move my troops into this cover to push the AI out of the fortification while moving up my guns. I'm also attacking near Bronner's farm. Thank you. My artillery being this close should push this unit out pretty quick. I'll charge them and the artillery with my KEV if I can get both infantry brigades to waver a route. All right, you're not supposed to be out here. Back up. Now I'll wrap my cav and skirmishers around to the back.
Thank you.
I'll get my assault up to the VP underway with the last phase about to start. We have 2.5 hours to win on day two. The contested timer for the VP is 40 minutes, so I have about 1 hour and 50 minutes to take it. There will be dedicated skirmishers defending the rear area, so you need to be ready. This is about to get ugly and disorganized. I'm going to charge with some of my units, overrun this position, and eliminate the guns so I can move my guys up in the cover. It will also make it easier to take the fortifications on the far left by attacking them from behind. I want most of my artillery and infantry to focus on pressing towards the VP. A couple of units work with my skirmishers and cav to clean up these orphan CSA units on the far left flank.
Thank you.
The rest of my reserve corps has arrived. These are all recruit units of skirmishers and minimum-sized infantry. Things are a little less chaotic now. My KF will clean up the routing units and everyone else will start moving towards the VP. It will just be a methodical push with the infantry and the artillery. I'll try to flank from the left with my skirmishers and cav, but it depends on how many units the AI has hidden back there. Casualties may be high.
Thank you.
I have 50 minutes to go this last little bit, so there's no need to rush, and I can just shoot it out for a while. I'll bring my cav up just to help repel the AI charges. If the AI infantry fall back, I'll charge its artillery. Taking the ridge makes the AI charge with all of its closest infantry units. I need to get some fresh units moved up to the ridge. Cover! I can start swinging this group around to close the gate and flank the last few units that remain near the ridge. In hindsight, I should have stayed off the VP and allowed the AI to keep sending men up to fight me, while at the same time mobilizing my reserves sooner on the right. Had I done that, I probably could have full cleared the battle. But as it is right now, the battle will end with the contested timer. I'm going to lose about 40 minutes worth of battle time that I could have used to do more damage. I had 2,112 men killed, 6,342 wounded, and 896 missing, for a total of 9,350 casualties. They, I had 20,300 casualties and 6,278 troops captured. Walton made Major General, and Wagner is my first Lieutenant General. Thank you so much for spending some of your valuable time watching today. I hope you found something useful for your own campaigns, and I wish you much success, generals.